Continue working on your file from the last movie. You can also open the file cityblocks-roads-sidewalks.max if you need to catch up. So now you have three city blocks with three different road layouts, but you still need to add sidewalks and building lots. At this point, you can hide or even delete the original road infrastructure you worked on, and the reference plane for that matter. Start with city block A. Select it and zoom in on it in the top view. In the Modify panel, go to Border Subobject Mode. This lets you select contour edges between rows, in effect, all edges around the hole, so to speak. Go ahead and select all the internal borders. Make sure the outside perimeter is not selected, as it is also viewed as a border. With the inner borders selected, click the Create Shape from Selection button. The default is set to extract a smooth shape. The problem is that a smooth shape doesn't follow the road edges properly. Press Ctrl-Z if you need to undo the last command. Click Create Shape from Selection again, but this time, make sure the command is set to Linear Mode and click OK. Exit Border Mode when done. You now have a shape that follows the road edges and that you can use as a path for the sweep modifier. Select the new shape, currently named Shape 001, and apply a sweep modifier to it. Set the sweep to bar mode with a length of 0.15 meters for the sidewalk's height and with a width of 3 meters. As discussed before, the sweep modifier operates by default through the center point of the cross section. Here, you need to adjust the pivot alignment so that the sidewalks are above the road level without overlapping the road surfaces. This means you need to use one of the bottom alignment options, left to right corner, depending how the border splines were created. The bottom left pivot preset seems to work fine in this case. It is possible that some splines are reversed, in which case, the sidewalks would be spilling over the roads. If this happens, you need to go down to the editable spline level and go into spline subobject mode. Select the offending spline and reverse it. This should take care of the problem. Back to the sweep modifier level, enable generate mapping coordinates and real world map size, and then go to the Material Editor. Create a new Arc and Design material and use the matte template on it. Make sure it is set to show in the viewport. As a diffuse map, use the bitmap named Road Sidewalk 01 diff.jpg. Set it to use real-world scale with width and height sizes of 3 meters to match the sidewalk's width. Apply it to the sidewalks, and this time, the bitmap is flowing in the wrong direction. Set the W angle to minus 90 degrees. This seems to work better. You may consider tweaking the width and height values. 3.15 by 3.15 meters seem to wrap around the sidewalk's edges a little bit better. If you want, you can use the image file Road Sidewalk 01 BMP JPEG as a bump map. Just make sure you give it the same specs as the diffuse map. As you test render later, you'll be able to tweak the bump strength. Set it to about 0.5 or 0.6 for now. Dismiss the material editor or move it away when done. In some areas, the sidewalk textures seem to be behaving, but not in others. In certain areas, it seems to be breaking away into a skewing effect. This has to do with the geometry subdivisions. Note this area, for example, how one corner is evenly divided with 4 cuts, whereas this other one has only 3. The trick is to add vertices on the original spline. Go down to the editable spline level, but make sure Show End Results is enabled to see the effect on the sidewalk's geometry. Go into Vertex Mode and use Refine to add vertices where you need them. Note how this seems to fix the distortion on the sidewalks. Go around the scene and make sure all corners have four cuts. Non-chamfered corners, such as this one, can have only three. This takes care of the long stretches of sidewalks. Corners would take a bit more effort if you need to adjust them as well. Keep in mind that if the camera is not getting close to these areas, you may not need to spend too much time on them. If you need to get the camera close, then you need to work a little harder to tweak the geometry. We'll get to that in a moment. Exit sub-object mode and convert the object to an editable poly. The sidewalk's cross-section being a rectangle, there are four polygons that go around each sidewalk segment. However, you really don't need to see the bottom polygon or the one facing inside, as there will eventually be a building lot surface to hide them. To remove all the unnecessary polygons, here's what you do. Switch to edge mode and select the top edge on the outside of a sidewalk element near the street. Click the loop option to select the perimeter edges on that unit. Hold Ctrl and select a similar edge on another sidewalk unit and press Loop again. Repeat until all sidewalks are processed. Once all these perimeters are selected, hold Ctrl and press the Polygon button to convert the selection. This selects the polygons that are connected to the previously selected edges and that you want to retain. All other polygons are unnecessary and won't need to show in the final render. They can therefore be deleted. Press Ctrl-I to invert your selection and then delete the unwanted polygons. From this point forward, you can fine-tune corners by adding segments to adjust the mapping. For that, you need to select the polygons that you need to edit and add geometry where needed using the Quick Slice tool, for example. Using this technique, you can adjust the corners further by dipping some areas to accommodate the pedestrian crossings or making the corners rounded if you need to. Take a few moments and go around your scene and tweak the sidewalk corners until you are satisfied. When you're done, you can attach the sidewalks to the rows and consolidate the materials using the methods you learned earlier. Remember that when you're done with the first city block, you need to repeat the whole procedure for the other blocks you created. Since this is redundant work, I will not go through it in this movie, but I encourage you to work it on your own. Ultimately, you can simply use the finished file you downloaded for this tutorial, but for now, we concentrate on the first city block. The next step is to create building lots, the surfaces where buildings and other structures will be located. This is what you do in the next movie.